cancel the presidential debates and cheat the voters? It could happen. Hello, I'm Steve Forbes, and this is What's Ahead, where you get the insights you need to help navigate these tumultuous times. Democrat operatives are starting a drumbeat to junk the three presidential debates, or at best, have just one very, very short one. This tells you all you need to know about what Democrat insiders really think about the mental acuity of the prospective presidential nominee, Joe Biden. Formal presidential debates have been a fixture since 1976. So why the sudden clamor by Democrats to scrap them? They and their media minions claim these verbal jousts are useless in informing the voters, that they're dominated by sound bites, and that anyway, Donald Trump would just unleash a tsunami of false facts. Sound bites do predominate in the primaries when you have numerous candidates on the stage. But this is the general election with two people, period. With the COVID crisis, voters have been deprived of the normal opportunities for sizing up candidates, such as campaign events and rallies. The nominating conventions will be shadows of their former selves. These debates are more critical than ever for learning about what Biden and Trump want to do in the next 4 years. In fact, the debates this time should be structured so that the candidates can give more in-depth answers than has been customary. Biden's proposals for massive tax increases need airing and examination about their real-world impact on the struggling economy. He especially needs to provide voters substantive thoughts on the riots afflicting so many cities, the rise in crime there, and what should be done about policing and the terrible inner-city schools. Not so long ago, Biden was dismissive of any concerns about China's activities. Where does he stand now? China is rapidly building up its military and has been aggressively expanding its power in the South China Sea and elsewhere. It may nullify our sanctions against Iran with substantive trade deals. A couple of weeks back, President Trump underwent a one-hour grilling with Fox News' Chris Wallace, which had the president fuming more than once. At the end, Trump opined that Joe Biden wouldn't dare face such pointed questions for 60 minutes. Trump is right. Wallace has repeatedly invited Biden and been turned down. If a candidate has to hide from Wallace or Fox's Maria Bartiromo, who hosts the highest-rated Sunday morning news show, what does that say about his capacity to handle the burdens of the presidency? The public should react furiously if Democrats try a cute maneuver, such as proposing that Biden will only debate if Trump releases his tax return. These debates are more necessary than ever before. I'm Steve Forbes. Thank you for listening. Do send in your comments and suggestions, and I look forward to seeing you next time.